Hey everyone, thanks for tuning in to Top Dog Tips. Today I'm going to talk to you about how to choose the best dog bed. There are so many different styles and sizes out there. How are you supposed to know which one is right for your dog? If you want some more detailed information on how to choose the right dog bed, you can also jump on our website. The link to my written detailed how-to article is right underneath this video. So you can click on that and get some more details. But I'm going to show you a brief video about how you go about choosing the best bed for your dog.
There are a number of things that you're going to need to think about before selecting the best bed for your dog. And the first is his measurements. And you don't need an exact measurement, but you want to know about how long your dog is so that you can know what length bed to choose for him. As you can see, we have multiple different choices of dog beds in our home. And Sadie fits on two of them, but the third one, she's actually a little bit too long for, so she's going to hang off the end. You also want to choose a bed that's made out of a good quality material. Now, the bed that Sadie's on right now is a Big Barker bed, and it's made out of orthopedic dog foam. You can also get beds like this one that are actually made with polyfill, and basically what they are is a large pillow that your dog lays on, which is great, but that foam on the inside squashes down just like the foam in your pillows on your bed over time. So what will happen is, and you can see on this bed, that the middle is kind of caved in and the outside is plumped up. So where your dog lays, you get that nice big divot. You don't want that because it's not comfortable for your pet. The bed that Sadie's laying on, the Big Barker bed, and other beds do it as well, they contain foam. And there's different grades and qualities of foam, but this one has a high quality orthopedic foam. And what that means is that this foam is made for dogs' joints, and when they lay down, it puts pressure on the joints. So these beds don't squash down. They are nice and fluffy. When your dog puts pressure on them, they poof right back up. So you don't have to worry about pressure being put on your dog's joints when he's trying to sleep. So beds like these with the foam are a really great choice. You also want to get a bed with a removable cover like this one. It zips on and off easily. If your dog has an accident, if he's chewing a bone on it, if he gets it dirty, you can easily zip it off and throw it right in the washing machine. You don't have to worry about trying to scrub a bed that doesn't have a removable cover. Is your dog a nester? Does he like to sleep propped up with his head on a pillow? You can see that this Big Barker bed that Sadie's on has a nice little cushion on the front so that she can lay on that. The traditional pillow beds don't offer that, but they are a little bit more form-fitting, and they kind of hug around your dog, so some dogs prefer that. There are beds with sides all the way around for dogs that like to nest and nuzzle in. So to quickly recap, the things you want to look for are a bed that is the right measurement that's going to fit your dog, a style that's going to fit in your home. Think about where you're going to put it. Is there going to be enough room? Is it going to match your home nicely? What material is it made of? Is it good quality? Is it going to last? What features are you looking for? Is your dog a nester? Does he have arthritis? And then, of course, the washing instructions. Is it going to be easy to clean and maintain?
Thanks for checking out this video. For more information, jump onto our website, www.topdogtips.com. You can also find all of the latest posts shared on our social media channels. We're on Facebook, Twitter, Google+. Of course, you can also subscribe to our YouTube channel to stay up to date with all of our video guides and product reviews, how-to videos, and all the great videos that we share on Top Dog Tips. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you back next time.